What? You don't. Stop whispering. You're over there. Speak words. I honestly don't care.
A double A manager has called one of his young players in for a quick word.
Every kid that gets drafted thinks he is on the way to the big league. That is just not the case.
The word is good.
You're right. Triple A affiliate. Whoa, let's go. Whoa, we're one step closer. Whoa, I got to Triple A so much faster this week. Well, not really, because I just simulated the game, which is why I got it faster. I didn't simulate that many games, so whoa. But I wanted to see our season. There, nobody would say that. Whoa, for real? Yeah.
Within 48 hours, this player will be in a new city and putting on a new uniform.
Nobody had any idea coming out of the draft. So I'm going to Triple A.
A Triple A manager welcomes a new arrival from Double A. This prospect showed promise at the Double A level. The organization is hopeful his progress will continue here.
Oh wow, I didn't. Oh no, I have to play against Gwinnett. I like Gwinnett because they're associated with the Braves. I don't want to play against please go harder and Lucas Sims. He's good. I'm going to get destroyed. Play next appearance. The Gwinnett Striper. Why did they change the name to the Stripers? Why can't they just be the Gwinnett Braves? Let's go change their name to the Stripers.
Luke, why didn't you get Minecraft?
Triple A baseball for you now on the show as we present coverage.
Cause what?
Now to the plate, Mark Valdez. It was a three-hit effort from him last night, so he was a big part of that victory. Comes set with the 0-1. He's on the ground at first. We'll see if they can get two. And he'll take this over to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner moves into scoring position at second. And with that, here's a glance at the starting lineup for the home squad. At the plate, Luke Poole. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ball game. First offering on its way. Line drive to center field. Decker patrolling center makes the play, one out.
Okay, here's the defense for the home team.
Striding into the box, Mark Valdez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Weakly to the left. Cool. Over to. Throw just does beat him to the bag as that was pretty close. Digging in to try it again. Luke Poole comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pagan is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. In now, Tom Romero. He reached on a single in his first try.
Patrick. Tom.
To short. Throw on to first in time, one away. Ready once again, Luke Poole, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Decker moves over. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Ken Pagan, due up for the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get some.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far. Really good at bats.
Throws in time, and that's out number one. Ready for another shot now, Jeff Decker. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Jeff Decker.
To short. Cool fields it. And quickly, there's one down to lead off the frame. Digging in once again, Luke Cool. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind it, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
The 0-1 pitch. On the ground to short. Could this be two? One there. On to first, and they get the double play. And that one run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. The Gwinnett Stripers took the lead in the second inning and rode.